I pledge allegiance
to the flag
of the United States of America
and to the republic
for which it stands, one nation,
under God, indivisible,
with liberty and justice for all.
Hi everyone, welcome to this week's Morning Buzz. I'm Stephen Popora.
Happy Friday the 13th. Don't worry, there's plenty of luck to go around this weekend with St. Patrick's Day approaching on Tuesday, March 17th.
Meanwhile, we'll have something else to celebrate Thursday next week.
This year, the spring equinox takes place on Thursday, March 19th. This day marks the first day of spring. The word equinox comes from the Latin words for equal night, aqueous, which means equal, and nox, which means night. For the last century, the spring equinox is usually on either March 20th or 21st, which means that this year, spring is the earliest we've ever seen. The last time spring was this early was 1896, which was 124 years ago.
2 weeks ago, Miss Morse hosted a special guest in the choir room, and the TV studio was lucky enough to get an interview with the rising star.
I'm Hariz, I'm 22 years old, and I am a recording artist from Los Angeles, California. Right now I'm doing a high school tour, and I'm going around just kind of promoting me and hopefully promoting the next couple singles and the EP that I'm going to be putting out. Well, I started with music in general when I was four. My parents put me in classical piano lessons. I kind of grew more into like singing more pop songs, and so I got really like involved with playing and singing. And at 11, I started writing my own song. I started my outreach. I did open mics when I was like 14, 15 to get myself like really out there, and going into writing sessions with friends and things like that. And eventually I got into bigger rooms. Eventually I said, you know what, I want to put out this music. That's what I've been doing so far. Last year I probably did around 50 shows, but this year we're definitely gearing up for a lot more. I'm anticipating probably 100 or something like that, 100, 200. Whatever your dream may be, it doesn't have to be music, because people have big dreams literally about anything, whether they want to be, you know, the person who creates the next best tech thing or whatever. I would say stick your head down, do your best, and really, like, you be honest with yourself that you're putting your time in and really feel like you're doing and giving what you can out of everything you can give. And I promise that it may not be right away, never usually is, but it will happen.
On this week's how-to segment, Izzy and Coco learned what it takes to put on a musical.
They sat down with Miss Roshan, Mrs. Cook, and Mr. White to learn more about Cinderella.
Hi, today I'm here with Miss Roshan to learn how to direct a musical.
I'm here with Miss Cook, the choreographer of Cinderella, and Mr. White, the music director. We're learning more about the behind the scenes of Cinderella.
Peanut butter jelly time!
What are some things you wish people knew about the behind the scenes of, like, directing the play?
For every minute that you see on stage, for every scene, it takes about an hour to put together the blocking before we even set foot in rehearsal. Blocking is the movement given to actors by the director. One important thing to realize is that all of this is entirely a group effort. Without our choreographer and our music director and our set designer, our technical director, none of this would be possible.
How do you work together creatively?
Our creative team brings many different experiences and expertise into what we're doing. So it starts when we choose the shows and discuss what would be best for our students here at Hopewell.
One of the things that I try to do is, given the rendering from our set designer of what it's going to look like, you use your imagination and try to picture, like, it. Why would it make sense for this character to move on this line? Where would they be going, and what are they feeling that causes them to behave in a specific way?
When I'm choreographing any number in the show, the first thing I need to do is meet with Miss Roshan and really figure out what part of the story are we trying to tell with the dancing, and then go to Mr. White, talk about the music, what we're going to be hearing, and come to the actual sheet music and look at what is happening from the orchestra side of things.
I feel extremely proud every time we get to the final product. It's amazing to see what talents the students have in all of the areas of what we're asking them to do, the acting, dancing, and singing. And those students who are playing music in the pit add the accompaniment that the show can't survive without. So seeing all those elements together and the amount of pride is hard to describe, and it's just part of that theater energy.
In a partnership with the athletic training classes, we're putting together weekly informational segments.
Athletic trainers are essential for the well-being and recovery of an athlete.
Because of proper care athletic trainers provide, athletes with minor injuries don't have to miss extended time.
For example, with an injury like a sprained ankle, an athletic trainer can get you back on the playing field within 3 days.
If a patient had gone to the doctors, they would have more time off because doctors usually give extended time for injuries.
This reason, along with countless others, is why we are so lucky to have athletic trainers here at Hopewell.
Last week's movie mystery featured a clip from Star Wars Episode 3, Revenge of the Sith. Did you guess it? If not, you have another chance. Can you name this week's movie mystery?
Robinson, apparently tired, punched with a fairly...
Come on, Ray. Come on. Come on, Ray. Come on.
Well, that's all for this week, everyone. Thanks for watching and have a great weekend.